Well, David Bridson is Head of Campaigns and Policy at YMCA England and Wales. David, thank you very much for being with us this afternoon. Does that report echo what you've been hearing from around the country?
Yeah, this completely shares the experience of what YMCAs are experiencing up and down the country. We have services that are funded from several different small pots, from local authorities that are struggling, and they're struggling to keep their doors open. Those services are so vital to make sure that the people who need them in the communities get the safe spaces they need, the trusted adults they want to speak to, and the enjoyment of being young and needing some fun. So we're seeing that pinch point across the whole country, no matter where people are, and that's why this funding is desperately needed as soon as possible.
Have you been able to get any clear explanation from government? I mean, we heard the statement from DCMS, that's just one part of government. Clear explanation for the government of why none of this money has yet been distributed?
I think there's a scarcity around the post-COVID build back, basically. Is the youth sector ready to receive a large amount of funding to deliver? And my message back to that is, yes, we are ready and we are primed to deliver for young people across the country. YMCAs have done a fantastic job through the pandemic. We've supported families through food parcels, we've delivered online youth services, and we've carried on with carers groups that we deliver up and down the country. We are ready to deliver, and we're ready to help young people build back and level up across the country.
You must have been slightly kind of mixed feelings when you heard the announcement for the Chancellor, at least has been briefed to journalists, that public sector pay freeze is going to end, because unless there's more money put into public sector organisations like local councils in England, they will only be able to fund increased wages by cutting further or finding more imaginative ways to save money in the provision of services. And presumably, because it's not a mandatory you have to provide this, youth service is one of the obvious things that goes.
Some areas we speak to have declared that they don't spend anything on youth services, and local authorities are one of the biggest funders of youth services across the country. That's why we need to make sure that we give the money to the places that are needed to actually give those services people need. We've got areas where there's nothing being spent, and if local authorities aren't spending the money, no one else is. We have services that rely on several different pots of funding to survive and actually keep their doors open. And that's the services that young people rely on, and that's what they need throughout. They need it reliably, not once in a while when there's a small pot of money going.
Is there a problem that, because people often hear, oh, we're going to lose everything, it's going to be shut, it's going to be cut, and there's a danger of crying wolf, which may not be fair to the organisations that are affected, but there can be a bit of a mismatch between what people hear and what they see around them.
I would say that is 100% not the case in youth services. We've seen 750 youth centres close. We've seen 4,500 youth worker jobs go. This is not crying wolf. This is a real issue that's going on in our communities. And that's why the funding needs to be delivered now to support those jobs, to support that recovery and build our communities back.
David Bridson, Head of Campaigns and Policy at the YMCA for England and Wales. Thank you so much.
Thank you.